the question is, if you have AFib that comes and goes, it's paroxysmal, is it a problem, or is there a long-term harm if you don't take medications? If you have paroxysmal AFib and it's not bothering you, well, then you're one of the lucky ones and you're in a good position. But what's very important is two things. One is not to ignore it just because you can't feel it. So, for example, if you had paroxysmal AFib and you had really fast heart rates, 150, 160, 170, and you still weren't aware, well, that can take a toll on your heart over time and can cause heart failure. We don't want that. So we would intervene, even if it's not bothering you, in kind of the usual way of symptoms. The other issue is, even if a whole suite of medicines isn't needed or recommended at that time, it's still important to think about risk factors. There's really good data to know that risk factor modification, including weight loss and activity especially, is helpful, and that can really minimize the burden of AFib and in many cases make it go away completely. You want to do that very carefully and in concert with a physician because, for example, if you're doing really great on that, you want to make sure that you can taper your medicines accordingly, but you may not want to do that prematurely as well. So it's a fine balance. It's hard to exercise for many patients if their AFib is also uncontrolled. So you need a little bit of control of the AFib just to get to do the things you want to do to affect those risk factors. If your AF is that mild, you may actually be able to get rid of that AFib if you do all the right things, the exercise, the weight loss, treating other risk factors.